Now to an X Factor scandal that's making headlines around the world.
Two judges have been booted from the Kiwi version of the hit reality show after an on-air tirade that leaves Simon Cowell looking like an angel.
I am embarrassed to be sitting here in your presence, having to even dignify you with an answer of my opinion.
These two have been labelled the nastiest TV judges of all time.
As an artist who respects creative integrity and intellectual property, I am disgusted at how much you have copied my husband. From the hair to the suit, do you not have any value or respect for originality? You're a laughingstock. It's cheesy, it's disgusting.
But don't you copy Cleopatra?
I personally found it absolutely artistically atrocious.
The New Zealand X Factor series took a turn for the worse when one judge took offence to a contestant dressing like her husband, who's also a judge.
It's like Norman Bates dressing up in his mother's clothing. It's just a little bit creepy, and I feel like you're going to stitch someone's skin to your face and then kill everybody in the audience.
The world is asking why. The real question might be who. Yes, who exactly are these two judges? Willie Moon is a Kiwi singer and Natalia Kills an English singer. The two are married and, as we've seen, together they're quite the outspoken couple. But it looks like fans had the final say, with the pair booted from the show for their comments.
For more, we're joined by showbiz commentator Peter Ford. Pete, did the judges deserve to be sacked?
Yes, absolutely. And look, I'm all for people speaking out and having opinions. And I think on a lot of these talent shows, including our own local ones, the judges are very often too soft and make all sorts of wild promises which are never going to come true. So I think that's the other extreme. But what we saw last night, I know people are saying it was bullying, but I think it was not really bullying. It was this sort of bizarre ramblings of people who didn't seem to be thinking of words carefully. They seem to have had a lot of strong cough medicine before they went on air. You know, I just don't think that they were sane, professional judges in the way they
and
were
they
conducting
people. And they do have an
people.
Inflated opinion of themselves, because that judge dresses like Michael Bublé or Il Divo or...
It's a suit.
He didn't invent the suit and tie.
No, it's just... That's why it's all so nutty. But I've got to say, before we got to say this right out loud, what a charming young bloke that contestant is to stand there and keep smiling and be professional. I mean, he's not a bad singer either. I've gone and looked at him. I hope he ends up winning just because he had to suffer through these two morons sitting there and doing it. So, yeah, they had to go, absolutely.
I'm sure public sympathy will be on the contestant's side. Kiwi musician Neil Finn has got involved in this. He tweeted that the judges wanted out, so they behaved like this to deliberately get kicked off the show.
Yeah, there's all those sort of conspiracy theories going on at the moment. I don't know. I would suspect that I'm not being mean, but I don't know that either of these people have got full dance cards for other work, so you would wonder why they would be deliberately trying to chuck in the job. You know, as we've had to explain here who these people are, they've almost had to do it in New Zealand as well, because let's be honest, that they don't work to the same budgets that we do. They have to do the show, the presentation and production has to be to the same standard. That's in the contract. But they can cut costs in terms of what they spend on talent fees. So therefore, they end up with these sort of D-list people, if you like. And look, if I was a producer watching that go to air the other night, it was live to air, I'd be somewhat conflicted, because you know perfectly well that not one person was going to pick up that dial and change the channel whilst this bizarre rambling was going on. But at the same time, you've got to say, can I afford to have these two loose cannon people there as part of a live-to-air show, because they clearly are hard to call on what they might do next.
I will never criticise Todd McKenney again. He looks like an angel compared with them.
I've been standing there like that fellow on the stage, so I feel for him. But I didn't even know New Zealand had an X Factor until today, so it has got them a lot of attention.
And they've got good talent on it. In fact, Stan Walker, who won here, is one of the judges on the panel as well. So there's a lot of good talent over there. So let's not say we're sending up Kiwi talent. We're not. But these two bizarre judges, I mean, you know, we thought Red Foo was a bit odd, didn't we? But boy, they've taken it to a new level.
No. Mm. All right, well said, Pete. Any successful Kiwi, we call them Australasian anyhow, don't we?